Hello, welcome to another reaction video workout. Today, we're looking into Kids See Ghosts, which is a collaboration album by Kanye West, also known as Ye, and Kid Cudi. Now, Kid Cudi is from Cleveland. I'm gonna wear some Cleveland Browns gloves. It's also getting colder and colder as the weeks go by, so eventually I'll need to start wearing gloves to work out. So I might as well train my hands to get acclimated to it. This is a short project. Project's like 24 minutes long, so I might not even get through my first bout of exercises, but I'm looking forward to seeing how this project goes. I've heard this bit.
Until we get back to you rappers, easy does it, nigga. I am more easy, you trying your best to become me.
I'm guessing that was Kanye doing all the gunshot effects. It's hilarious sounding, I love it. Can't tell if this is an outro or intro to the next song. So impressions on the first two tracks, we had Feel the Love and Fire. So Feel the Love is interesting to me that this is a Ye and Cudi collaboration, and in that track Push T was the first verse. And Kanye's verse was just kind of going just playing percussion with gun ad-libs. And then Fire, it was a decent song. It wasn't anything too crazy so far. So far, it feels like this is a passion project, just something for the fans, more or less. We're gonna keep it going. Keep hearing what's going on.
It feels so good as she comes. Bought an alligator, I ain't talking the cost.
Yeah, I know this one. Alright, so that was Fourth Dimension. Definitely recognize it from the beat and the Lacoste bar. And that was mostly what I recalled from it. I do gotta say, the production of Cudi on here, I think it's my speaker, honestly, 100% it's my speaker, but it just kind of gets muffled in the sounds. So it's a little difficult for me to hear what he's saying. I'm just kind of like hearing his voice. In a sense, same with Kanye, or with Ye as well. So far this album has been very heavy on the marching drums sort of sounds. And it is being carried in that sense with the drums. So I can't. Yeah, I don't think the vocals are supposed to be the important part necessarily to it. I think you come back and listen to it and hear the vocals, which is what I'll be doing. Might be my favorite. All right, so I think so far that's the most memorable track, aside from the ones I've heard before. I'd say coming off of this and I hadn't heard anything, this is the one that would stick in my head the most. The sonically is really like droning sounds to it. It's the most experimental I've heard on this project for sure in the last couple Kanye or Ye projects. I think this is the most it reminds me of a little bit of Death Grips, actually. And I think one of the interesting bits to it is using cacophony when he's doing that bit there. It doesn't really match the other parts there, but it catches your ear. He's using that cacophony to make a brain worm, or earworm rather, for it. So I think that was really cool. So definitely a song I've heard, and it's a song that it's very motivating, especially when you're in a dark place. A lot of Cudi's music is geared towards that, as we know. I think it was placed in a very good spot on the album too. It's a bit melodic. The beginning of the album was a lot more amplified, and as it's going, it's getting a little more mellowed out, a little more just easy listening. And I'm going to re-listen to this before I give final thoughts, just because I want to really settle it in, and it's short enough I can do that, and see if there's kind of like a storyline a little bit going, because I feel like there's something. Let's keep it going. I think it's like two more songs.
It's nasty!
Listen, babe, right on the breakfast ahead. Anybody who said that I was better off dead. Told him don't ever leave nothing that you ever read. Got a Bible by my bed. Oh, yeah, like building in the building by a loser.
Kiss it, go sometime. Kiss it, go sometime. Kiss it, go soon.
Find your own peace. Bring light to what they don't see. Auntie crying on the concrete.
So, final thoughts on the project. I actually don't really have time to listen to the whole thing again, because just got a few more sets left. But I would say Cudi, this feels more like a Cudi project. The first few songs kind of had more of a Kanye beat to it, I would say, with the drums and all that. And then it sort of went into more of the transient droning that Kanye likes to do in his sounds. And also, just hook-wise, I mean, Cudi was really, he did a good job on the hooks. It had memorable type of things, songs that were going through there. I do need to re-listen to it and hear again what the, like, just lyrically, what they're talking about a little better. Especially something like this in both of their career is a lot more introspective as opposed to flexing on hoes, you know what I mean? So when it becomes more introspective, it gets a little more poetic, a little more thought needs to go into here, and then you can't just kind of chuckle and keep going. So I would say that there's a good chunk of this for entertainment, like, you know, the beginning kind of lull you in, but as it goes through the album or project, whatever this is, it's a lot more, it's more of something that you want to listen to on your own, in my opinion, or listen to with your mates, you know, and just kind of chill out to. So what I worked out to this, a couple songs, and it was just better than Ye? Definitely was better than Ye. Yeah, those are my thoughts here. I'm going to listen to it again. I don't know if I'll record those thoughts, because it's worth listening to again. It's pretty solid track, but yeah. Thank you. Have a good day. Focus.